Hey guys, welcome back. Really excited to have you guys here with me. Thanks for clicking on this video just a few weeks before Christmas. Thought it would be a really good time to get this video out there and hopefully not be too late in helping you guys pick out a Christmas gift. If you're watching this, you know, outside of Christmas and whatever, that's totally fine too, because all of these gift ideas are really good for any occasion, whether that's a birthday, an anniversary, even Easter, honestly. Valentine's Day as well, beautiful. So these gifts are, as the title suggests, a little luxury oriented. That being said though, they are not hugely expensive because I understand everyone has a different budget. Some of us have really low budgets and some of us have really high budgets. So I wanted to kind of give you guys a mix. Now I have a bunch of items in front of me, you know, that'll help you guys kind of get the ball rolling, I suppose, on gifts. You don't have to get these specific items that I'm suggesting, but it will give you like the ballpark, like the area kind of category that is really, really good to get a gift in the luxury space, especially. I know a lot of my viewers, you guys, I love luxury stuff, especially because this channel is so luxury focused. So even if you are shopping for yourself, these luxury ideas are really, really good. So I'm not going to go through these items in any particular order. I'm just going to pick up whatever that's closest to me. There's not that many. I'm looking at about 4 or 5 different items here, and hopefully it'll be very, very helpful for you guys. But to all of my dedicated followers out there who have been following me from day one, I just want to say that I have absolutely no words to express how thankful and how appreciative I am of you guys for sticking by me through this. My life recently has been a bit of a mess, to say the least. I've not really been in the best of places, but I am still doing this because it's so much fun for me and I love sharing this sort of stuff with you guys, and I love kind of putting my opinion and also I guess putting my uniqueness out into the world. And I've created this little space for me on YouTube, and I'm working on a different project as well to create a little bit of space for myself in the world. So that project will come soon. It's still a lot of work, but without any further ado, let's jump right into it. So the first item or the first category that I want to touch on is something that is very season specific, especially for Christmas, with these brands, and it is the holiday packaging for the luxury beauty kind of branding, I guess. So I'm talking about things like Chanel, Dior, Gucci as well. They have perfumes and lipsticks and whatnot. What else is there? There is, you know, Bulgari does makeup. I think they do makeup. Hermes is now doing makeup as well. So all of these luxury brands for fashion, traditionally for fashion, now have kind of like cosmetics and stuff. And for Christmas and for the Christmas season, they do season specific packaging. And, you know, there's kind of two, it's like a bit of a twofold. So you can either go with one of these, which is the season specific packaging that provides you with like a pouch or an extra item that kind of houses it. So for this one, I have the 2019 Dior Rouge lipstick collection. So it came in a case like this, and I did an unboxing last year for my Christmas gifts, but it came in a case like this with I totally blanked on what this is called, but a carton, right? So it came with like a carton, kind of like made of foam, like a carton here, that housed like 5 lipsticks, and you obviously have the mirror up here as well. So I think that this kind of packaging is really, really cool. You kind of get the Dior branding, or you get, you know, whatever brand it is, you get that kind of branding, and it's not really expensive as well. This was 5 lipsticks for, I think it was $189. So it was really, really good price. And I think it's totally worth it for myself. You know, the lipsticks were great as well. And also I got a clutch out of it. Now for you guys as a gift, either you could give the whole thing to somebody, and I think that's also really, really special, or you could give the lipsticks, wrap them up, put them in a nice little package, and then you can give the lipsticks as a gift to people, and then keep the case for yourself. So it's kind of like a two-in-one thing. But I think that this is a really, really good idea for a gift for somebody or even for yourself, because it's definitely something that is lasting me a really long time. It's a year later, I'm still using this clutch every single day. I'm using the lipsticks as well. It's fantastic. Kind of along the same category as well. Still going on like luxury branding packaging for the season. You have specific Christmas packaging. So this particular one is, so I mentioned before that there were two, kind of like a twofold category for this. So you have the extra item, which is, you know, like a pouch or a clutch or something, or you can go with their standard lipsticks and beauty products, but buy them with the special Christmas season packaging. So for this one, it was actually a gift from Michelle, my best friend, and she got me this Gucci lipstick in the Christmas casing. So usually the Gucci lipsticks don't come like this, but for 2019 Christmas, it came in this beautiful golden embroidered metal casing, and it just, it's incredible, this particular lipstick. I mean, it's not plastic, you know, it's metal, it's thick, it's expensive, it feels expensive. And I don't think it breaks the bank. I haven't looked up how much this was, just because I have a thing with the presents. I've been kind of like grown up being taught that you don't really look at the price of a product for a gift. So I don't remember how much this is, but I don't know how much this is, but I'm pretty sure it would be something less than $200, probably like $129, even maybe less than that. Generally with lipsticks, that's about how much they cost anyway. So you can get the actual product, but just in a very, very special Christmas packaging. And I think it's really nice. It's just perfect. And the same kind of goes for like other products as well, right? So I've got another one here, kind of along the same lines, but just a little bit different. This one is the Christian Dior J'adore perfume. And I have this in the Eau de Parfum, because I find usually with the toilettes, it's a little bit too weak for my taste. And I just, yeah, I like the parfums because they're stronger and they last me the whole day. So this is perfect. This and this actually is perfect if you have a friend or yourself that you know uses a specific perfume or a specific lipstick or some other beauty product, whether that be foundation, concealer, anything like that. If you know that they use those sort of products and you can see that that brand, that specific product is now coming out with a season or Christmas season specific packaging, I think it's actually a really, really good idea to go get them that particular product in the Christmas packaging, because that way, you know, like, I don't know about other people, but for me, when I get a gift for someone, I always worry that it's going to be a waste. I always worry that they're not going to like it or that they're going to put it to one side and just really never touch it again. So with my kind of gifts, I always think of something really practical, you know, so I've gotten jars for people, really fancy jars. I've gotten bathrobes. I've gotten slippers, you know, like things that are actually really helpful in the everyday life. Because I just don't think, especially in today's world, that there's much room for wastage. So it's always good to be a little bit more conscious of what you get for people, because if you make sure that they use it, then the products and materials that went into making them isn't going to go to waste. Because eventually, if you get something for someone that they're not ever going to use, like, it's just going to gather dust and they're going to throw it out without ever really using it. Yeah, so this I think is so, so good. Now, I know that Dior is actually doing engravings for all of their products, and they're doing like mass marketing this year. Last year, it was reserved for their beauty VIP customers. They had special invitations to them and to get that, to get their products engraved. This year, it's like a media, like mass marketing. It's all over Facebook. I'm seeing it all over Instagram. And yeah, like engraving is like a big thing at the moment. So if you know that you have a friend who always uses, for example, the Chanel No. 5 perfume, or if they always uses the J'adore, or, you know, some other kind of perfume, and it's coming in a very Christmas specific packaging, I highly, highly recommend that you just go pull the trigger and get them that, because they will love it because they already use it, which, like, you know, they already use it, they already love it, so they're gonna love your gift, and it's gonna be used every single day, and it's not gonna go to waste. So I think it's a fantastic idea. So the next item I wanted to talk about, oh, so you know, a product like this, you're probably looking at a few hundred dollars. So that's kind of like the middle range. The next product I'm going to talk about, that's right here, is actually on the cheaper end, and it's the perfect time to go out and buy one of these, because it's now, the sales are coming around. Net-a-Porter have come out with a 50% off, Matches Fashion have come out with 50% off, and you've got all those other shops that are coming out with 50% off as well. My biggest tip is hold off on looking at those sales for now. Wait a couple weeks until Black Friday rolls around. Or actually, I think by the time this video goes out, Black Friday would have been over already. So fingers crossed, you guys. I hope you've already shopped really well on the Black Friday sales. I hope you guys picked up some really good deals. If you didn't, that's still okay, because I know a lot of shops actually hold their sales all the way up to Christmas because they know that shopping is gonna happen, right? So they do, and they're trying to entice their customers. So if there are sales going on at the moment, then I would highly recommend giving a thought to buying something like an SLG or an accessory, whether that's a phone case, a bracelet perhaps, a ring, earrings if you have a friend that wears them, you know, something like that. And I would definitely recommend something like this, because a normal retail price, so using this as an example, this Prada bracelet retails for about $320. I got this about 4 years ago, or 3 years ago actually, and or 2 years, no, I think it's about 3 years ago I got this. And I bought this off Net-a-Porter. It was a 60% off sale, and then it was taking a further 20% off after that. So I ended up getting this for about, like, I think like $90 or something like that, maybe a little bit more. So that is something that is very, very affordable, and it doesn't break the bank. So if you are a person, if you want to shop for yourself, and you're a person that's really maybe not earning that much money, but you still really love luxury, highly recommend still having a look at the sales, because you can actually find luxury items for a huge bargain. With these sort of things, and having said that though, you do need to think about your friends and your family, whoever you're buying a gift for, and whether they'll like it. If they don't like it, if you look at them, you know, like a big tip, spend a couple of lunches with them, go out with them a little bit, and have a look at what they're wearing if you're planning on buying jewelry or accessories for them, right? Have a look, are they wearing earrings? If they are wearing earrings, what kind of earrings are they wearing? Take them out to lunch two or three times, and kind of like take note, right? So if something small like this will probably be about between 50 to 100 bucks, and I think it's really affordable and a fantastic gift idea. Yes, now something that might break the bank a little bit, and on the higher end of the scale, is a card holder. Now, I know a lot of people might be thinking, oh my god, you know, there he goes again talking about a card holder, because I think everyone recommends a card holder. But you gotta think, there's a reason for that. People recommend card holders. People on YouTube recommend card holders as a gift idea, as the perfect starting item for starting a luxury collection. You know, they recommend a card holder all the time because it is a fantastic item. It is actually a fantastic product. Whether that's a gift or as just anything for yourself, if you're starting out your luxury collection, card holder, you cannot go wrong. Me and Yoshi got a card holder for Yoshi's mum for her birthday last year from Chanel. That was about, I think, like maybe $900. So it was just hitting the $1,000 mark. This particular one was also $900 from Dior. So you're kind of looking at about, this is the upper range, right? So we've got the mid range, which I've already spoken about. You're looking at like seasonal packaging from beauty brands and stuff. Or you're looking at like the lower end of it, which are accessories on sale. Such a great great gift item. And then on the upper end of the scale, you've got your card holder. So I think card holders are so popular because they're just so easy to use. You kind of just slot your cards in there, and then if you don't have that many cards, actually, you can take the cards out from the middle and put cash in. And you can always just keep coins in your pocket, but I think these days a lot of people pay with card anyway. But yeah, like I think a card holder is so good. It's perfect. You cannot go wrong with this. And I really don't think there's much more to say. Like, it's simple to use, it's easy. People are going to really appreciate this because they can just take this, put it in their pocket, don't even need a wallet, don't need a bag. They get this, they get their phone, and they're done. It's just honestly so easy. And I do actually want to make an honorable mention because this particular item I think is so good. And I got it as a graduation gift, but I don't think that you need to spend this much money. There are definitely cheaper versions. And for those of you who remember what I got for a graduation gift, well, that's amazing. But for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, I'm actually referring to the Apple Watch. Now, the reason that I say this is a fantastic gift is because I got it, as I said, for my graduation from my mum. This is the Hermes version, and this was about $2,500. You do not need to spend this much. The Apple Watch does not cost this much. And you can always get the cheaper version as well. So they're currently just released the Series 6. The Series 3 is still on sale, so that's the like couple of generations ago, or you can get this Apple Watch SE, which is kind of like the budget version of the Series 5/6, I believe it is. So you can pick the Apple Watch that is within your budget. If you can afford an Hermes Apple Watch, I highly recommend it. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I do have to be honest with you guys though. The only difference between the Hermes Apple Watch and the standard Apple Watch is that you get the Hermes branding. That's literally it. Oh, and you can also get the Hermes watch straps as well, but you can just get a standard Apple Watch and then buy the watch straps separately if you want. Like, you can go into Hermes and buy the straps separately. So there really isn't any difference. But it was a graduation gift for me, and so I was like, why the hell not, right? Like, you know, I might as well just get the whole thing. So apart from the branding, that's about it. Not exactly a luxury item, because this can go for in Australia. I think the Apple Watch Series 3 is like 239. The Apple Watch SE, I think it's about 329, and the Apple Watch Series 6, I think is like 499 or like 399, I think, or something like that. So this is a mid-range priced item. It can be on the lower end as well, about $300, $200. Honestly, though, I think this is so great. My life has just been made so much more convenient because of this. I ping my phone when I can't find it. It gives a ring when I've, like, for example, left it in the bathroom and I've forgotten it. You know, I find my phone. It's so easy. What else can it do? I swim with it. I work out with it, so it marks my like workouts. Keeps track of my activities. It's so good. There's also an alert for when you like slip as well. So if I slip and fall, you know, it'll detect that and it'll send like a message out to my emergency contacts if I don't turn it off, which makes it a fantastic gift for your grandparents or even your parents as well. My family is going to be getting an Apple Watch for my grandmother because she's 90 years old. And she's still on her own 2 feet, which is absolutely amazing. And because of that, she's still mobile. She showers on her own. She doesn't need assistance. She's not in a home or anything. She still lives with my auntie. And she kind of more or less takes care of herself in terms of her personal needs, going to the bathroom, showering, and stuff. But if she was to slip and fall in the shower, no one would know because the door would be shut. Unless there was a big bang, you know, no one would know. But if she was wearing the Apple Watch, you know, she'd slip, she'd not respond. 10 seconds later, an alert will go out. We can respond so quick. My grandfather, that's kind of how things started going downhill. He slipped in the shower. He lived on his own. He slipped in the shower. And no one found him for, I think, 8 hours. Keeping it on a positive note, it is a really, really good gift idea. For a friend as well, for a couple of $100, you and a few friends could like maybe chip in together and get it for a friend for Christmas or something. And I think it's such a fantastic a gift. It's just so useful. You can text, you can take phone calls on it. You can listen to music if you have a subscription to Apple Music. It's absolutely fabulous. So I would highly also recommend the Apple Watch as a gift. And on that note, I think that's about it. I don't have anything else in front of me. There's nothing else that I can come up with in terms of a good gift idea. So that's about it. If you guys have any good gift ideas, I would really like to hear about it because it's not just you guys getting gifts for people, it's also going to be me getting gifts for people as well. So, if you guys have any good ideas, please leave it in the comments below. I would really like to hear about it. And if you haven't subscribed as well, please do hit that subscribe button. It would mean incredible. It would mean so much to me. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really appreciate your time, and I will see you guys in my next one. And I hope everyone has an absolutely fantastic holiday season. Bye.